Jiji ni yahu.
Jiji ni yawenye jiji wale wanatembea.
Nairobi is for the poor people.
Nairobi ni nyumbani.
It gives me a pleasure to welcome you here tonight for the launch of Jiji ni yahu festival. A critical reflection of the good, the bad and the ugly of Nairobi.
Jiji ni wasanii baba. Jiji ni kila mtu mwenye anafanya kazi kwa njia safi.
We are putting Franco-German friendship in the service of a peaceful and just world. Who does the city belong to?
The Moving Nairobi exhibition sets out to capture the city through the eyes of four commuters traveling by foot, Uber, Boda Boda, and bus. The visualization shows how these commuters weave through the Nairobi's breathtaking traffic congestion.
Africans never used to own cars. You guys used to walk. You continue to walk, 40% of you. But what we want to bring in the city is reliable, affordable public transportation. Jiji ni yahu. Jiji ni yawenye jiji wale wanatembea. So when you see many cars here congesting the city, those are not the owners of the city. If we talk democracy, then the city belongs to the working public.
My name is Sophia Bauer and I'm working as a sound artist. I'm also part of the team of the Sound of Nairobi Collective, which has the aim to record the sounds of the city and to store them and for research and also to document the history of the city through sound. 2020 happened and the COVID-19 pandemic hit. So we started this project called Sounds Like a Pandemic, short SLAP.
So far we've collected around 113 recordings. Data scientists find this kind of data interesting, especially ecologists and ecological data scientists. There are researchers as well who work on this. So it's open access for reuse, you can remix it, you can use it to create whatever you want.
The archive can be accessed through the web address soundofnairobi.net. You record your own history, that is the idea. And whatever you find relevant to be recorded for the future, you should record and upload to the website.
Story, story!
Story, come!
Story, story!
Story, come!
I heard this story from the oratorists.
What?
I swear, it is true.
No.
Let me tell you the story of Nairobi. I heard it said that Nairobi's recovery from the COVID-19 pandemic is slow. A new administration comes into office following the 2022 elections, promising to prioritize pandemic recovery in its program. I was told that to celebrate its 60th anniversary, the United Nations Environmental Program, UNEP, becomes the first United Nations body to move its headquarters from Nairobi to Isiolo, which is a new upcoming smart city.
Each and every evening, Nairobi is unsafe and unpredictable as the inspectorate has carried attack and extort small traders along the streets of the city.
Haki yetu, haki yetu, haki yetu, Nairobi usilale,
lale, lale, Nairobi usilale,
bado mapambano, mapambano, mapambano.
But however, there is some good news. The East Africa community puts in a bid for joint hosting of the year 2046 edition of FIFA World Cup. Nairobi is designated as a key host venue. A good thing is coming home, people. The coming of the celebrated FIFA World Cup to East Africa is a once-in-a-lifetime golden opportunity. Preparations completely transform the Nairobi city. Nearly every Nairobian is gainfully occupied. Good times never lasts. But when that fairy tale football carnival finally comes to an end and everybody goes home, the age-old haunting ghosts of Nairobi rise up in their full splendor. Full audit of the tournaments reveals pervasive corruption that virtually underwrote each and every aspect of the World Cup.
When the annals of the 21st century are recorded, one city in Africa will stand out, Nairobi. And what a story that will be.
It's 2070 AD, and Nairobi has transformed. You will not believe it. Nairobi is no longer part of Kenya. Nairobi is an independent city-state. You're wondering, how did we get here? I will tell you that story, how we got here. But let me tell you about Nairobi in 2070. It is one of the best cities in the world. It's one of the most peaceful. It's one of the most prosperous. It's one of the most inclusive. One of the most democratic. I know you can laugh. You think that you can't imagine the future. It is also one of the most dignified. In this Nairobi, it is a world leader.
Stop dreaming.
Jiji ni hau nikiconnect na story na hii mambo ya river restoration. Hii river ni our responsibility juu iko ndani ya Nairobi. We really value environmental conservation. Environment is there to stay. And if we don't act on it, it will act on us. Na iki act on us, itakuwa on a very negative thing.
Wajuku is an art group. We teach kids through art. Mostly they do recycling materials around them. We started with cleaning the small sewage lines in the community. Sometimes they are clogged. What we are doing with the kids is showing them the danger of having the sewer lines so dirty, so we clean them up so that the water, when it rains, goes smoothly to the river. And when we come to the river, we have started a tree planting initiative where we are planting trees, and around the tree we are recycling plastic bottles, the mosquito nets from the river, and some sizes from the river also that are used to make the fence around the tree to prevent the goats and other animals from eating the plants.
My name is Francis Ndungu. Hii river kuna venye na chenchingi kala, sometimes unapata iko red, sometimes unapata iko blue. Kuna streams inaongeza capacity yake, inaweza kudhuru watu. Sasa kama kuna zile effects za kama bilharzia, waterborne diseases, plus tena daraja zinaenda na hiyo maji. Getting filter, plastic flow in liter. Tell me who's to blame when pollution getting deeper. I think it's time to heal up. This the way, no more waste. Time to be the leader. Say world, we got to heal up. Wajibu wangu tuanze
leo, ni wajibu. Let's go into Nairobi before independence.
We will be covering about a century of Nairobi. We will look at the colonial city, what we inherited. And then later on, the post-colonial settlement comes in.
There'll be three tours, as you can see. The upper part where we are, which is the Biashara Street side. Then the middle part, Kenyatta Avenue, and a little bit south of Kenyatta. And then the River Road area.
Nairobi as a settlement started at around 1900, and it was picked as a spot for administration purposes. The site that Nairobi sits on, the western part, I would roughly equate it to Kikuyu land. The eastern, southern part to the Maasai community.
Our next stop, ladies and gentlemen, will be the Jivanji Gardens.
This happens to be the only garden that is found right in the middle of the city. Here we are at the city market.
The Binga Market, the building was put up in 1930. It is a national monument. Duke Street, which is currently known as Ronald Ngala Street. Ronald Ngala Street is a place where Nairobians pick their buses going to Eastlands. Those who live in Kayole, Umoja, even further north to Zimmerman, pick their vehicles from there and Githurai. The Goan community had put up a club during the early days of Nairobi. The very first president of the Goan clubhouse was Dr. Ribeiro. Dr. Ribeiro was well known for traveling around Nairobi on a zebra.
Nairobi grows and Nairobi lives, and Nairobi is a consumer of the people who supply its energy. And the energy of Nairobi is touts, the maid seller, the boda boda guy, the guy who does sewing machine, the cobbler, the shopkeeper. One day in Nairobi, you can cycle to work, you can safely walk to work, you can take a train to work, a tram to work, and Nairobi belongs to all of us.